and action.
You know, it's so strange to hear Brandon call action because I'm usually the director. I'm coming straight from a premiere in Durban. We just had it. Absolutely amazing. The castle, go catch it in theaters right now. We came straight. You can see I'm still wearing the same clothes. And I came here for an important, very, very important interview. It couldn't be held back because we've got someone who not only is a social media influencer, he has 1.8 million followers. Can you fathom that? Can you put that in your head? 1.8 million rand. Well, I'm saying million rand, million followers. And let me tell you something, he's such a great guy. I've gotten to know him behind the scenes and, you know, we've been talking about a lot of things. And I want to introduce you to Calvin Reeve. Calvin, welcome to the show, Hot Bites.
Hello. Huh?
How you doing?
Very good on yourself.
You know, when Brandon called me up and he told me that he had this major influencer and I asked him, how many followers does he have? He said 1.8 million, I almost fell off my bed.
Yeah,
you know, almost rolled off. I mean, 1.8, you must be really proud of the work you're doing right now online.
Definitely, 100%, yeah.
You know, this show is all about getting to know celebrities and getting to know people on an in-depth level. I'm sure you just told me you did an interview in Australia and you've done some interviews overseas on NBC, ABC, whatever it is.
One of the major networks.
But on Hot Ones, what we do here is we eat some wings, we talk some rubbish, and you know what we do? What you saying over there?
Hot Bites.
You sure it's Hot Bites? I'm sure I named it Hot Ones. You sure?
Yes.
Is it?
It's Hot Bites, yeah.
You guys are sure about this? Yes. It's Hot Bites. In fact, yesterday when I was talking to Brandon, he said, don't forget to call it Hot Bites. And I said, I'm a professional. But obviously I'm not. So we got to move forward. But anyway, this is not about me today. This is about Calvin. Calvin, I want to know, who are you? What do you do? Where do you come from? How did this all begin? Talk to us.
Honestly, it was all just a surprise for myself. You know, I never really thought I'd be where I was at this point of my life. I was always studying and I was gonna work for my dad doing construction and to hopefully take over his business one day. And then just randomly I posted a video and my first ever video got, I think, 1.7 million views. I looked like somebody called Lil Huddy, apparently. Back then he was some famous TikToker. He's still a famous TikToker. But and then, you know, I posted that video and I got over 10,000 followers in a day. And I was like, no way, where is this actually going to take me? Can you earn an income? Can you do all this type of stuff? I never knew about it. And I started posting more and videos actually just did terrible then. And I was like, oh, okay, no, I just hit my luck.
Yeah.
With that one video. And I kept on the ground probably 2-3 days after, you know, posting around 10 videos. Then my videos just started doing well again, like 2 million views, doing a point of view video. And that was like where I realized that's my niche.
Yeah.
I need to do like emotional, make people cry type videos.
Wow.
And then, yeah, this is where I am.
I watched some of the videos. I cried. But I cry for anything. So that's one of those things. I watched The Notebook the other day. No, I didn't. I didn't. You know why. But you know what? That's great. And I love the fact that you have success so young. I mean, you just turned 21. You're turning 22. And I think sometimes success young can be overwhelming. But we'll get to that.
Okay.
Talk to me who you were before the success. Tell me about the individual.
So, you know, basic teenager, wild, naughty, as usual. Then... I think I went to college. That was my main thing, studying. I started studying strategic management. And then throughout, COVID happened. And that's where I knew where I was going to, I don't know, that's where I branched out. And I started posting like random videos. And, you know, but before, I was just a normal teenager.
A lot of people who come on the show, especially influencers, say that COVID kind of perturbed them and kind of pushed them into the social media thing because they didn't know what to do and it kind of was something for them to do during that time. Was that the same for you?
Yeah, it was like more of like, I'm bored, what can I do?
Yeah.
You know, and then that's how it randomly happened, especially that everybody was on social media. So it helped others grow even faster because now everybody was just stuck to their phones doing nothing. And
do you think that COVID was a catalyst for TikTok to be such a success here?
In my scenario, yes, I do believe it. But, you know, a lot of people were already big on TikTok before COVID, but in my scenario, yes.
Yeah. I was with a colleague last night and we were watching your videos and it's quite unique. There's a new unique stance to it because TikTok is so full of, it's full of content. And sometimes it's very hard to know who to follow because there's just so much out there, you know? But your videos, it's very niche, as you said earlier. There's something about it. And how did you develop that style?
I was a very good writer in school. I could write very emotional content. You know, I got really high marks for writing and my main thing was to try and get the teacher to be emotional. So, you know, that's when I think I just used that form of talent and I brought it to more of a video content type of, you know, way. And people really just did enjoy, they enjoyed being able to relate to something that no one really speaks about, if you get what I mean. Like, you know,
give me an example for the viewers that don't know, that haven't seen Calvin Reef yet. Give us your TikTok handle while we're at it.
At Calvin_Reef.
Always marketing. Always.
I don't know
marketing.
Which camera to look at because they're both.
Look at them all.
Like three
one,
looking at me.
Two,
so.
Three. Look at
which
them
one?
All.
Is that the main one? Okay, look at that one.
So as I was saying, tell me a little bit. Give them an example of the content.
Basically heartbreak. There's so much different stuff. There's kind of like, there's videos on the dark side that it's just, I don't know, I can't really bring up. I don't know if I can bring it up.
Like
but.
The Sith.
It was said that you would destroy the Sith, not join them. Bring balance to the Force, not leave it in darkness.
Just no, like heartbreak, what is it? When you're an addict.
Give us an example. Like, give the viewers, they're going to go check your stuff out. Give us an example.
That's so hard. It's too hard to think of.
What's your most famous video? What's the one with the most views?
It was basically a video of myself where I was talking about weight and for example, there's a new boyfriend. So I'm the ex-boyfriend and I just broke up with, or me and my ex-girlfriend just broke up. And it's basically me seeing them like in a skit, and I'm basically, it's so hard to explain in third person, but the new boyfriend basically guys, this is too hard. Okay, wait, can I restart that? Are you gonna be able to cut this?
Yeah. No, okay. We're not gonna cut it.
No, you can't cut
it. No,
this.
Just keep going. Wait, we're not cutting things here.
I need to look at the video to explain
this
it.
Is hard bites. We don't cut things here. Let's go for
okay.
it.
Okay, new boyfriend basically talking about my ex-girlfriend's weight and mocking her about it and me being sad about it. it's hard. That would be much easier. If you guys could show that video, thank you. Because it's very hard to explain. But
I like the explanation. The explanation was great, right, Brando?
Yeah.
It was great.
So
we'll do that. Let's play that video right now. Okay. How's that video? That was great. Great stuff. Heartbreak. People are fat. I don't know. Today, it's not politically correct to call someone fat anymore, is it?
I don't know.
Stop this. Stop this, Calvin. Stop it. Let's move on. So you know what? You know, a lot of people on TikTok and social media think that this is easy. And we know as content creators, myself and Brando, there's a lot of work that goes into it. There's a lot of money that goes into it. I mean, your time is money, right? And they think that you just take out your phone and you do something, but they don't know how much of time and effort it goes into creating one video. Take us through your process.
Yeah, no, it definitely is harder than people think. Mainly figuring out content. There's so many different video ideas, and to keep up on trends. If you don't keep up on a trend, your video is not going to do well. Just actual, you know, videography of yourself. You know, you get the skit wrong so many times. You got to like memorize. And just mainly, I think the biggest issue would be ideas. For me, it's coming up with ideas. It can take up to like a day just to figure out one video that hopefully will do well.
Do you ever suffer from writer's block?
Writer's block?
What's kind of like writer's block where the idea is not there.
Yes, all the time.
And you're kind of harsh on yourself. Come on, I'm sure we can figure it out.
Yeah, like I honestly, the way my brain works is that I'll have to like sit on TikTok. I don't know why, and I'll just scroll. And I won't find an idea or find a video like that I could use, but I'll listen to sounds or music, and therefore I can like bring up an idea listening to music. It's really weird. But that's just how it is for me. But it is very difficult. It's not an easy process. In the beginning, it was much easier because I had so many different ideas. But once you've posted over, I think I've posted more than 400 videos.
Yeah.
You get to that point where you're like, what else could you make?
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
But that's why I am branching myself out to do different types of content now, especially YouTube vlogs as well.
How important is diversification?
Pardon?
How important is diversification in content creation, creating different types of videos for different types of markets and demographics? Is it important now because there's so much of content on TikTok and on Instagram and all of those things competing? Do you think it's important to create different types of things for different types of people?
Definitely, most of it, yeah. For me, I do specifically keep to my niche. It's what I'm good at. I have tried to, you know, do like dancing videos and all those type of things. Don't watch them. I think there's only one on my page. And
I do some dancing.
I'm not the greatest at it, so don't even watch it. But yeah.
Interesting fact, I am a multi-platinum recording artist. I've got a platinum record.
Like singing.
Interesting story. Once I was on stage with my back, this is not about me. Stop laughing. My team is laughing in the back. Once I was on stage with my backup dancers, big event, right? Vodacom event. And my foot went through the stage. And I finished the whole performance when my backup dancers trying to push me back up. Can you please, my team in the back, can you please keep it down? I mean, this is a professional setup here. Can you please behave yourselves? Please, Brando. Fire some people, man. Fire some people. Huh? I don't know. My follow-up question to that, Calvin, is that it's so much your work to make these things. And we know everything as a content creator, what it is. How do you feel about people buying followers? And it's a question I know that a lot of influencers, when you hit them with it, they kind of go, I'm not buying followers. You know that? But it's not a question. That's not what I'm asking. I'm asking you, I've watched your stuff. There's so much of effort that's gone into it. How do you feel about people taking the short? And I know there's a lot of policies and stuff now coming up with YouTube and stuff. If you get caught, you get banned and all of those things, but it's still a real thing.
Honestly, I don't mind people buying followers, in my opinion, because to be honest, people that do buy followers, they don't get the return that they would want, which is
because you don't get the engagement.
You don't get the engagement at all. So, you know, at one point in my life, I did think of buying followers.
That's quite honest.
Yeah.
That's very honest.
But just to get to that, like, you know, 100,000 mark, and I think it was just too expensive, to be honest. So, yeah. But I won't ever buy followers. Don't worry, guys. I won't do that. But then I realized I did a lot of research into it. I know quite a few people that have, and I've seen their engagements, and, you know, they're getting 1,000 likes or 500 likes on a photo or video, and it just made me realize. I was like, oh, okay, there's no point in even doing it. I'd rather just grow my own, you know, followers, especially at the state of like time, I was just not growing anymore. I was putting in so much effort and my followers and stuff just weren't going up. And I think I focused too much on followers at that point in time in my life. And then I just basically got, you know, over the concept of followers and more, you know, what
consistent
I'm doing.
Content.
Yeah. And consistent
and the followers
content.
Will come if the content's great.
Yeah. I never started it ever for followers. And I just, you know, brought my mindset back to that, you know, where it's not for followers. It's not for anything. It's just more for, you know, helping others, therefore, that's what my content is based on, so.
Yeah. Well, you know what this show is about, Hot Bites. That's it.
I'm very stressed.
The name of my own show, with LX Seth and Brando. And today we've got a Mishka here. So it's Brando, LX Seth and a Mishka. But here we go. So what happens is that these are chicken strips. It's strips we've made ourselves. We spent all night cultivating the recipe. And the sauce is something that gets exponentially hot. I see you've brought your girlfriend here today.
I have,
Taylor.
Yes.
Taylor, how you doing? And you will be eating some strips with us. So we all die together. So how's your tolerance for heat?
Terrible. Terrible. I can't even have like too much pepper. So I think I'm going to struggle on this, but I'll try my best, you know.
Did we sign that release form, Brando? So if you're going to sue anyone, Brando.
Yeah, I'll take the cameras.
Just go straight for this guy because he didn't have the release form signed, right?
Say in camera that you give consent to eating.
Can you just do that quickly? Just quickly in camera.
I don't give consent.
Wow.
And I will be taking the MacBooks and the cameras if anyone.
Wow. Not mine.
I'm joking. I do give consent. Don't worry, guys.
Fantastic. No, we know you're joking. Well, okay, so let's try. So the first one's called the BAM, which is basically...
No, that's not the first one. it?
Yeah, okay. we're calling it the BAM.
Then the BAM.
Yeah, okay. So this is the BAM, and it's basically, it's very mild. It's really, I didn't eat all day, so I'm very hungry.
Well, go for it. It's really hot.
What?
What? Are you guys messing around? This is so hot already.
This is entry level.
Mm-hmm.
This is the entry level one. Mm-hmm. Is it hot, Taylor?
Mm-hmm.
That's all right. Chill out.
Mm.
I don't have to eat
I'm just going to have to eat bites of each one.
No. Yeah, that's fine. Just put this back.
That's good, though.
I'll put it back. Okay, all right. Let's put that. Okay. Well, it's the first time on Hot Bites that someone said the first one is hot. Guys, what do you all think? Is it hot?
Is it the first time we've got milk as well?
Yeah.
It's the first time someone's... And it's with someone with 1.8 million followers. That's great.
God, this milk is so good as well.
Is it?
What milk is this?
I just normal. Actually, I don't want to tell anyone. We got our own cow.
We got our own
cow. We have our own cow. And we milk it. I'm Indian, you know, we worship the cows. Okay, all right. When did you... It does have a bit of a kick to it. It does. I think these ones were kind of left in chilies for 2 weeks, so it's quite hot. But it'll get better. It'll get more tasty.
Okay. It's definitely nice. It's just hot.
At what point did you kind of feel as if, hey, I'm becoming successful on this platform? And now, when you start to see the followers coming up, your content getting better, what's the next step?
So due to COVID, we weren't able to ever go out or anything like that. So no one really recognized me or anything. So that it was nothing about recognition. It was more about a brand deal. I was the first time I ever was able to make money off of, you know, social media itself. And that was, I think, the point of my life where I was like, you know what, like this is getting like better or bigger. And I think definitely that was the first concept, and therefore, you know, I don't know, like that's the first time I ever like think that I was, you know, not famous, but up there. Yeah. And then I actually went to the shopping mall. Still hot. Sorry, guys.
it's part of it.
Okay.
Part of the thing there.
Jeez. So the first time I actually went up to a shopping mall, and two people recognized me. So I said, hello, guys, whatever. Took some photos with them. And then I went to Sunglass Hut, and next minute I come out of Sunglass Hut. I'm not too sure if I was with Travis or another friend of mine, Matthew, one of the two. And we walk out, and there's maybe 10 to 15 people waiting out there for photos.
Yeah,
and that was definitely the first time I'd ever, you know, felt that feeling of being recognized.
Let's talk about that for a second. And I know that fame can be daunting sometimes. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
You really have more milk? Our cow is outside.
Yeah.
We got more milk.
It's like every time I swallow, it's like it's hot. I don't know why.
Yeah, well, it's Taylor, are you okay? Yeah. It's all right. It's okay. Fame can be daunting. I mean, you know, you're not famous, and then suddenly you are famous, and people know you, and then now you suddenly have to protect your brand, you know, and you know what it is. I mean, even coming on a show like this takes a lot of decision. I mean, is the show credible? What are they going to ask me? Is it going to affect my brand positively or negatively? How do you deal with fame?
Honestly, as you can see, I'm very socially anxious. So I'm not really much of a talker. So I am if I get to know you well.
Yeah.
And
but you also have great energy. There's something about you that has just great energy. Are you a drinking man?
Drinking like that?
Yes. Okay.
Not all the time, but yes.
You see how protecting the brand.
Sometimes.
Protecting the brand. I don't get drunk at positive bars sometimes. Yeah.
I don't. And not every day.
Yeah. Not every day.
On occasion.
Sometimes it happens to all of us.
Yeah.
I'll tell you an interesting story about Brando in the South Coast, but that's for another episode. But how do you deal with it? I mean, it comes with a whole bunch of other things. It comes with stalkers. It comes with sometimes fans. A lot of people don't discuss the negatives of social media, you know, where there's a lot of people who give you positive feedback, but you also get a lot of negative.
Mm.
How do you deal with that in terms of your psychology?
Negative feedback, honestly, just I don't really care.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to happen no matter what.
That's a great answer.
You know, even if you're the best person in this world, the nicest, it's going to happen. So I just, you know, look past that.
Yeah.
I look at the bigger picture of it all. They're just laughing the whole time.
What's up there? What's happening there, guys?
I want to know what's
is,
so, yeah.
Is things okay there? Is things all right? We're shooting a show here, guys. Is everything, should y'all leave? Should y'all leave the show?
The hot stuff.
Oh, is it okay?
Is it that hot?
Are you feeling
it's
it?
Yeah,
it's hot.
Okay.
It's hot stuff.
But yeah, no, basically, yeah, as you said, I just look past it. I look at it.
I always say I hope the critics will kill me, but I hope the dreamers will embrace me. Mm. I always say, because you can't please everyone. We've got, when we did Toklush The Calling and we released it worldwide, the international markets, some of the greatest critics, the most acknowledged critics were, that's a 7 out of 10, that's an 8 out of 10. And then you get people, these pucho people on Twitter and stuff who are not critics that are like, this is a 0 out of 10, we could do better. Because everyone thinks they can do it better.
Yeah.
And when you're in the public eye, that's exactly it, you know. Do you think there's a lot of crab mentality in the TikTok community where, you know, people are not supporting each other, they're just trying to pull everyone down?
Yes, 100%. There's a lot of different, like, I've seen personally a lot of, not on my page, luckily, but where people come together as like a group and just bring a video down. And I don't know, I do see that often, especially like how everybody will just gang up on somebody just because other people are ganging up on them. And even if they believe like that it's not a big issue, they'll still just gang up on the person just to, you know. I have seen that often, so yeah, 100%, yeah.
So the bam is still on our tongue. You can feel that. It's a lingo on the tongue. Can we get a shot of this, B? Can we do that real quick? Get some iPhones out here. Let's take a shot. Let's do it. Calvin Reeve. It's so nice you took a shot of me first.
Yeah.
So good.
Yeah. How you doing?
Can we get a shot of Taylor? Just sitting there eating the strips. It's insane. Okay, should we go in for the mild?
Yeah,
we can. We can.
Let's go in for the mild. Let's go. It's a nice chunk. I think this is going to be...
I'm going to take even a smaller bite now.
I think this is going to be tastier.
Eat the whole thing.
Really tasty.
Mmm, that's good.
What do you think, guys?
Mm. Mm? Not as hot.
It's a tasty one.
Oh, wait.
What we like to do is hit you with the bam and then keep you going. Keep you going. It's good. Not as bad, Taylor. It's not as bad. It's mild. Mm. Maybe we got it mixed up. It happens sometimes.
The first one kills your taste buds.
Mm. So you don't feel anything anymore. Mm. That's what it is. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
You don't need that.
I would love to, but it is hot. It's good though.
Yes. I'm using my fingers and all. Because I'm Indian. That's how we eat. So tell me about the darkest period in your life. I mean, this show is all about getting to know the individual.
Definitely when I was around 15, 16, my friends, I joined the wrong friend crowd and I got very badly influenced with, drinking, etc., all those bad type of sort of things. And I focused a lot on that, going out every weekend, every second weekend with them. And just drinking all the time. And I think that was just my darkest stage. I also became very depressed and emotionally unstable.
How long ago was this?
15, 16, so around 5-6 years ago. So a lot of my content also comes from that, I feel. Especially getting out of that situation, having that friend group and feeling like if you leave them, you're not going to have anybody. And which I did eventually. I left them.
Were you empty? Were you vacant? Were you void at that point?
Yeah, I was very by myself, focused on myself, self growth. And I think I just branched up from there. And yeah,
it's difficult when you're in a space like that. And I think everyone can relate to it. When you're in a space like that, you feel so helpless, and you feel as if, how can I pull myself out of this rut? And sometimes you wake up one morning and all the answers are there, mm-hmm, for you to just kind of find that energy to kind of... Do you believe in the universe? And do you believe that the universe pushes you in certain places? And
I
in energy, negative energy? Like if you join positive people, you are positive. If you join negative people, because I believe that.
Mm.
And I went through a phase, I'll tell you a story, where I kind of woke up one morning and divorced my entire life. My friends in it, they weren't serving me at all. And I just wanted to find something more positive. I wanted to find a system. I believe that we're all in a system, right? That was healthy enough so I could grow, you know? And it's very easy to be caught up in friends who want to drink all the time, you know? Because that's where they want to be. But obviously, when your ambitions are bigger, you've got to find other people who you kind of...
Definitely. They were holding me back and, you know, I needed to move forward from that.
Yeah.
So
yeah, well done.
Yeah,
well
thank
done.
You.
And you know why I bring that up on the show is because there's so many people out there right now still in that place. And if they're watching it, like I always tell my friends, read autobiographies because you learn how other people get through things. You know, it's easy to see someone at a successful stage and go, wow, they must have had it easy. Everything was given to them. But no one sees how you wake up every morning and fight for that end result. And even when you're there, you have down moments. You have 1.8 million followers. I'm sure you still have days when you feel low, days where you feel, is this going to be consistent? You know, how do I keep my followers? You know, it's self-doubt. You know, it's imposter theory, right? Where you don't believe in yourself enough sometimes, you know, to say, you know, can we keep going?
Yeah, 100%.
But yeah, no, 100%. Now, in terms of, before we get to the hot and then the bam bam, how do you make money out of the social media thing? Are you making money? Is it, if there's kids out there who want to be social media influencers, how do they make some money?
Brand deals. A lot of brand deals. Basically, a company will reach out to you asking you to, you know, showcase their items or their products, and you'll advertise it on your page for either payments or for products. If you, and you really like, I've worked with companies where I honestly just want to keep the product. Like, for example, Bug Assault. It's like this gun where you can put like salt in it and like shoot bugs.
Bug Assault.
I do not enjoy. Yeah, I do not enjoy bugs. And it made it so fun. Like, this thing was a
bug
big shotgun, and you could shoot a bug. Like,
do you have it here?
Meters. I don't.
We could shoot some bugs.
I got two from them, and
I could shoot these two buggers here. These two buggers here.
It was probably my favorite product I ever got. But yes, as well as record labels, I personally do. I work with music artists and helping them advertise their music. And yeah, and it obviously, it, for me, more my social media is my... What is it? Portfolio for acting. Yeah. So that's where I want to be.
You want to be in our movies? I mean, we create movies. And we are shooting a music video. So me and Brandon did a track. We're shooting a music video at a club soon. Pull in. Let's have some fun.
I've been in two music videos now, yeah.
Okay. So. Flexing.
I enjoy it.
Which music videos? Talk to us.
Afrikaans music videos.
Okay. Biggest market.
Yeah. Snotkop and Shay Lee was one of them. And then another one was Shay Lee as well. Separate, you know.
Yeah. Okay, all right, let's get to the hot. We're going to change batteries quick, but stay with us.
Ooh, we're back.
Hello.
I would say that we went away for a commercial break, but we didn't.
It's the next day.
We're actually rushing to our next premiere in Joburg. We're actually leaving tomorrow morning, Brando. Mm-hmm. It's going to be crazy. It's in Joburg, Emperor's Palace, Catch the Castle, in theaters. Have you watched the movie yet?
What movie? Catch the Castle.
The Castle. We just did a psychological thriller called The Castle. It's been released nationally through New Metro and City Center. If you've got a moment, go and catch it with Taylor. Taylor, go watch our movie. Support local. Okay. That's what we need. Should we go to the hot? Should we try the hot? Let's try this. Let's try it. Let me just, you know.
The worst is I'm taking like smaller bites.
I'll give you a smaller bite.
Yeah, I'm taking it smaller now because like I'm worried.
I'm like feeding him now, like I'm his mom. I'm like cutting it up and shit.
Okay.
Let's go. Let's go for it.
I can already tell this is going to be hot.
No, this is a good one.
This is my favorite flavor so far.
This is a good one. It's like a peri peri, right? Oh, wait for it.
That's a problem. I've been waiting for it.
Wait for it. The slow build up. It's a slow build up. It's all right. It's not bad at all. It's tasty.
This is my favorite one. This should probably be mild, I think.
No. We don't.
No.
We
can't. Or maybe the bam.
The bam needs to hit you. The first one needs to hit you so you get something needs to happen in your... Okay, here we go.
No, but it's good. No, it's not as hot. I don't know. Maybe it's just my taste buds are getting used to it, but...
But isn't that great?
Yeah, I am taking the smallest bites as well, so...
You know what we... You know why we established this show? So we find random white people and tell them the Indians. That's what we're doing. It's our... I mean, we started with Brandon, and now... we're making our way through Mshlanga and Belito. So watch out. Watch out. I think one of the days we're going to get a random fan to come on this show. Brandon, you said that that's what we plan to do. So that's going to be exciting. What's the future holding for you? And what's your future plans?
Definitely, as I said, acting. It is my main... It's what I've always wanted to do. I am doing a movie at the end of this... Well, beginning of January, end of this year in America, which is like quite crazy. So Atlanta, to be exact.
Wow.
So I partnered up with a team there. They asked me to do auditions. I had to do it, obviously, the auditions from here, sent through my like taped auditions. And that's my, I think, the biggest thing. And it's closest to what I've always wanted to do. So I'm excited for that, yeah.
What's your favorite part of being a social media influencer? And is that what you like to... Look, these days everyone is calling themselves that, right? Let's be honest. What would you like to call it? What do you call yourself? Because I mentioned you as that. But obviously you see yourself as something else.
An influencer, yes. I do believe, obviously. Everyone has different terms for it. For me, it's just more... I don't see myself specifically as an influencer, but others do. So, you know, I take it as an influencer. Yeah.
So, in terms of duration, how long have you been doing this for, in terms of duration?
I think just 2 years now.
Wow. Yeah. And what's been your favorite part of the whole thing?
When I moved to Cape Town, that was definitely the biggest deal that I ever did.
Are you based in Cape Town still?
No, Belito now.
Okay.
But I was based in Cape Town for a year for work.
And what were you doing there?
So I actually joined, we made a group of influencers, like a Harp House type thing, but a South African version, which was called the Smash Boys.
Okay.
and we made like, we got all the hoodies and everything, and we saw this house, we moved up there. That was probably the most exciting thing because it was new, it was different.
So, unfortunately, let me just get this wrapped around my head. A bunch of influencers say, let's get together and synergize. Mm. You'll move up to Cape Town, stay in the same house.
Yes.
And the goal of that was to create content.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
And unfortunately, we didn't have real management hour, so we just didn't really work as well as we could. People were very lazy in the house, and I think we had the potential to make something big out of it, but we just, you know, never. But obviously, everything happens for a reason.
Yeah.
So,
no, it's a learning experience.
Everyone's still on good terms. We love each other. You know, we
great
good
lies.
Friends. So,
great lies.
Yeah.
Because like. It's hard to live with people. It's
no,
difficult.
It is
it's
really
difficult
hard,
stuff.
You know?
It's difficult stuff.
Getting people to clean. I like to be clean. So that was my major issue, was getting people to clean.
But sometimes Brandon comes to my house, he leaves everything. He leaves everything in the room and that sort of thing. I've banned him from coming to my house. But that's a story for another time. Like the other day I went, so we've got two offices at my place. We're just up the road, right? And I went into his office and there's three Red Bull cans and there's coffee from the... I don't know about this guy.
It's the late night editing. You gotta get on the grind.
Excuses are not gonna work it here. Let's try one of the BAMs.
What is the difference between the BAM and the BAM BAM?
Well, one will kill you and one won't.
I can already see the BAM BAM is like dark colored. It looks, yeah.
It looks great.
It looks deadly.
That looks great. There we go. Right. Okay. Let's taste this.
I don't have a big bite.
Okay.
Sounds good. They're all so good though, the flavor.
It is quite nice, it's not that hot. Do you need more water? Can we get some more water? Can we get our producers to get more water here? Thank you so much. Producers laughing there one way, I don't know.
Yes, please. As well, thank you.
Just getting more supplies. Because this one is hot.
Are you eating the whole thing?
I'm good.
Are you? Jeez.
For the Bam Bam, you have to eat the whole thing.
You have to eat the whole thing for the last one.
Well, that's like the worst one to do.
No, but you've gotta eat the whole thing, yeah.
It's the experience. Yeah.
It is.
It's the experience.
But they're tasty, They're really tasty stuff. They're really tasty.
No, it is really good. Like,
that's why we always tell people, don't eat before you come because it will...
No, it is really, really good.
Yeah.
The flavor, just the heat.
We're just waiting for water refill before we continue. Just bear with us. Bear with us for a second. Looking through my notes here. What do your parents think of this as a career option? And tell me something. Are you studying? Are you pursuing education? Or is this something that you are... full on?
At this moment, I'm full on. Before, I was studying strategic management, 2 years. Beautiful. And then, as I said, I moved with a few boys to Cape Town and I stopped my studies. Still got 2 years credits at least. So yeah, I can always go back if I need it. But my dad, he was not happy with it. Well, my stepdad, I don't think he was happy with it at first because he was paying for my studies and he wanted me to focus more on that.
Difficult sell.
Yeah, and it was just more hard for him to understand, like, hey, how are you going to make a living off this? And then I had to link my international banking to his F&B account because I didn't have an F&B account. And then he saw my first payments and he was like, well, okay.
Yeah.
You know, you can actually, I think he became more understanding. My mom's always been my number one supporter, you know.
Moms usually.
Yeah, I love my mom.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, she definitely,
Shout out
was
to
happy
moms.
With, and my real dad was also very, very happy. You know, once he also saw that I was doing well, but yeah.
It's amazing how people, as soon as they see success, they start to support something, but they don't see the vision initially. You know, I'm not saying it's a negative thing. I'm just saying it's human nature, isn't it?
My stepdad's very old school. He's, you know, he's so smart and very, he's just a productive person. He gets things done. You know, he owns a very big company in South Africa. So, you know, that's where he believes real success comes from. So he couldn't really see or understand, you know, he's not a social media person. Now he loves TikTok, so he actually scrolls through but he just watches construction videos. I don't know why.
Because he's in construction. He wants to learn.
Yeah, he loves construction and stuff. So he's a civil engineer and quantum surveyor, and he has bought 2 degrees and then owns a construction company.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
And I was I actually really enjoy construction myself. Like I've always actually enjoyed it, but he made me work from the bottom and I was literally making
like Drake. Starting from the bottom, now we're here.
Yeah, so I was basically, you know, messing around with, what is it? Concrete, making concrete every day for like a month. Wow. From 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. every day. And I just couldn't do it anymore. And that's actually also, while I was doing that, I started TikTok and then I quit his job. Or quit the job. I was like, no, I'm not doing this anymore.
I see why he wasn't happy. And then,
yeah, but no, he's actually become a very, you know, he supports the things I do now. And he's, you know, I'm sure he's very happy we have got him in my life. So.
My dad is also a civil engineer, believe it or not. And we've got another engineer there. Amishka, you do some tiling in your spare time, don't you? You also do some concrete work, don't you? You enjoy it? She knows how to mix, she knows how to do a lot of things. Yeah, concrete is one of them. Tell me something. And I ask this to most influencers when they come here. Where do you see, as someone who's in the arts, when I say arts, I'm saying music and in film, feature films, I'm always looking at where the trajectory is for the industry. Mm. You know, I saw the music industry change business model that go from analog to digital. And I always say this, once you start to democratize, you demonetize, right? So when you're looking now at where influencers are going, what do you think is the next major platform? Because TikTok is not going to be it forever. What do you think the next one is? You think the metaverse is going to play a role? Talk to me about where you see it going.
Honestly, I'm terrible at social media. I'm not a social media.
Yeah.
Personally, I'm not. As I said, everything just sprung up on me and I've just actually learned my way throughout trying to be better. I barely post or photos. You guys see that? I hate photos. So. Honestly, I think there's always going to be a platform. Social media I don't think it's ever going to really, is it called the metaverse?
The metaverse,
yeah. That might be a bit, you know, I don't know anything about that stuff, but you know, maybe it might branch into that, but at the same time, we have our platform, so we're able to get all those people to branch out from there to the next thing. So it's not too difficult to start something new once you have, you know, that base.
Assimilation accommodation. Yeah. But isn't it crazy that, like, you're 21, you're going to be 22, right?
Mm.
But a 16-year-old now or an 18-year-old is so different to who you are because they grew up in a completely different ecosystem of things, you know, and technology and that sort of thing. If you talk to a 16-year-old, 18-year-old, they're so much more mature than you were at that age or whatever the case may be because they're growing up with all this information, you know? When I was growing up, we read books. You remember all that?
No, you don't. I've never read a book in my life, ever. even through school, I got my mom to read the book.
I like audiobooks. I like to listen. But yeah, but the thing about it is that's what I'm saying. I'm saying that the new generation is so tech savvy, you know, which, and they're growing up faster because they have access to all of this information, which I think is insane. And I think the metaverse, when they talk about it, what they're trying to say is that everything, your life will change because you throw on some goggles and now you can basically have your meetings. You can work remotely. You can meet your friends and play games online, all in this virtual world. And that might be the future where people are so antisocial, you know, and we're seeing it now with social media. If you go out to supper with your friends, everyone's on their phones. It's an absurd thing that you're there with people, but you want to be with other people, you know. So it's a very interesting future we're looking at. I'm not sure where it's going to, but it's going to be very interesting to see. Should we try the Bam Bam? Now, the rule with this is my DOP there says you got to eat the whole thing. I'm not sure why he said that, but
I'm going to try my best. I will try my best. I'm so stressed. Okay, but I will.
Don't you think Brandon's like a terrible person?
No.
Like,
shame.
He wants you to eat the whole thing. Come on.
Okay. One bite. Is
yeah. No, okay, the whole bad. Thing. Whole thing. Okay. Let's go.
I'm going to try half first. Cause
no,
I,
no, 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 the whole thing.
Whole thing.
Let's go with
it. That was the biggest bite I took. Half of it.
That's so good. I can feel it when it's going down your throat. You can feel it. Now I can feel it on the side of my. Oh God! All right. Producers, can I get some water here? Can I get some water for this? Wow, wasn't that bad?
Mm-hmm.
It's all right. Because
I did half.
Gums are starting to bleed at all. Did you have the same thing? Really?
What?
Okay.
What?
They didn't give her the right one. Because mine is crazy.
I think they're just acting tough.
Yeah, this is acting tough here, like Travis. Travis was like, this ain't great.
I phoned Travis before this, and he said, no, it's not even hot.
Whoa. Well. What we do is every time we have a guest, we improve on the recipe. And with your one.
Is mine a bit hotter?
Well, our DOP there, it's a build. You a champagne drinker? Okay, all right.
I'll drink anything at the moment. I
just need. Brenda, give me those two glasses of champagne. Now, you are on this very special episode of Hot Bites, because we've had a very successful launch of our movie. It has its last week in cinema this week, and it's been very successful. We just signed it internationally to a company in Los Angeles called Terrafilms. They're going to release it internationally. We are so excited. We start our new movie next week. We start this big documentary in June. So this episode is here to celebrate all artists, and I'm glad that you're the one who's here to celebrate.
Thank you. Congratulations.
And you're such a great guy. Champagne. And I hope this doesn't go everywhere. Wait, let me get... Am I in frame? If I stand up, am I in frame?
No.
Okay. All right, I don't want to get it... Like, usually when I open Prosecco, it gets all on...
I felt like it was... Oh.
Did you get that?
I thought it was going to shoot.
Did you get that? How is that? It's great. So let's toast. Let's toast to us. Let's toast to the future. And you know what? It's going to be amazing. Ooh, calm down.
It's hot now.
Amishka is looking there like, give me a glass. There we go. Ooh. Do you want a glass? You sure?
Fine.
Yeah.
Would you like more water?
Thank you.
Whew.
Thank you.
Here we go.
It's like, even my eyes are like...
Your eyes are burning. Yeah.
Don't touch your eyes.
I won't.
Let's just pour this. Let's just pour some.
I'm like trying to cool it down with my hand.
So, in closing, I hope you've had a good time here at Hot Bites. Let me just open my thing. Calvin, in closing, I want you to look at each camera and I want you to tell everyone what you're doing, where you're heading to, and where people can follow you and catch your content.
Okay, cool. I need to like learn one of these outros, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, wait, repeat.
But it's okay.
What am I telling them?
Just tell them what's your future hold for you, where they can catch you, your handles and all of those things. Just tell them anything you want to know.
Hey guys.
You can look at all of them. Look at all of them if you want. All of them.
Do a
drum thing. Yeah, yeah, go for it.
And must I repeat myself when I do it?
No, just we're not cutting all this. This is all going to be like, just go for it. Just go for it.
Oh yeah, you can follow me on @CalvinReefOfficial. @CalvinReef_official on my Instagram, TikTok @CalvinRee_Reef, and YouTube CalvinReef. Those are my main three platforms. And yeah, you're probably going to be seeing me in a movie in the next year or so.
Can you talk about that movie?
That's weird. I can just, I honestly know a brief idea, but basically I'm going to be in love with another person and I'm going to have a sickness and I think maybe, I don't know if I'm going to die or not yet, but.
Taylor, how do you feel about this movie? Yeah. Taylor's like, it is what it is. Yeah. Taylor's like, it is.
I was excited. I was waiting to see who I'm, doing it with.
Oh, you should have caught her face. Did we catch that? Did we get that reaction? Put that in.
I'm playing.
But you know what? Calvin Reef, thank you so much for coming on Hot Bites. It's Hot Bites, right?
Yeah.
Huh? And I just want to say all the best to your future. It's going to be bright. You have such great energy.
Cheers.
Even your girlfriend has such great energy. Taylor, team, thank you so much. Let's toast to success. Catch us on YouTube. Subscribe. The only way we get paid is if you hit that subscribe button. Right? Bam, bam, baby. Bam, bam. Brandon, you want to say anything?
Bam, bam.
You sure?
But you're such a bad guy. Let's talk about that for a second. Why you wanted to kill this nice man? Huh? Mm.
Wait, Todd.
But it's good.
But it's good.
It's good. It's good.
There you go.
Mm.
Honestly, I think leave the bam, bam where it's at and maybe make the hot a bit hot.
What?
I think the mild,
like a crescendo.
I think the mild should be half of what it was, mm-hmm. And then you gotta have something in between mild and hot, like medium. Where's the medium?
No, we don't need medium. We are exponentially hot.
No, it can't be mild and then hot. It needs to be mild, medium, hot.
There was one that was kind of tasty and had nothing on it.
Honestly, I think the hot was like not that hot, but I don't know if it might have been the other things that ruined my
the first one, the yeah. Bam, that kind of,
because the bam bam I think would have definitely way hot, would have been hotter if I tried that first 100%.
Yeah,
so because that bam there in the beginning was really hot for me. So
okay, are you taking the notes here? I mean, we're just getting some constructive criticism here. Just, you know what,
I think
who's making these strips?
You.
It was me. I made these strips, that's for sure. Such a pleasure having you, and I hope I see you.
Thanks so much for having me.
Guys, thank you. Subscribe.